like.
And I'm Jeremiah Deep.
With the Super Bowl in our midst, we can recall some of the best parts of the Super Bowl, which is the hilarity of the commercials that millions of dollars are spent on each year.
Memorable commercials such as the Volkswagen commercial with young Darth Vader and Budweiser Stallions are just a few multi-million dollar commercials we see every year.
Stay tuned to LCTV and check out some highlights of the best Super Bowl commercials from yesteryear. What's your favorite Super Bowl commercial, Jeremiah?
My favorite one? I have to say the one last year with the little Darth Vader. I thought that was really funny and how he went right in front of the car and his dad, you know, clicked it and he thought he had all the powers. I thought that was probably the funniest one I've seen.
I really enjoyed it. I really liked the one where they were all on the couch and they kept like, wasn't it like Oprah or something?
Yeah,
that was really funny. I liked that one.
You know, it's funny. I mean, the Super Bowl, millions of people watch it just for the ads. I mean, it's some people don't even really care about the game or the outcome. They just want to see the Super Bowl ads.
And then, well, they used to watch it for the halftime show, but then, you know, that Black Eyed Peas show last year wasn't.
You know, I was looking forward to
so
that.
Up to par.
I was a fan of them, and then they just, that was terrible.
I was really
disappointed.
But Madonna's coming this year, so hopefully.
Kelly Clarkson, she's singing the national anthem.
Kelly Clarkson.
So it'll be good this year.
It should be hopefully.
Good.
Yeah, hopefully.
Yeah.
So be sure to check out that website and be sure to check us out on Twitter and on our YouTube page. I'm Erin Van Slyke.
And I'm Jeremiah Deep.
And we're here for LCTV.
I'm not sure what it is. I guess I'll be okay.
I'm calling the studio, Matthew. You're not shooting today.
No.
People are depending on me.
Movies bring so much joy.
Stop. It's done. Just get some rest.
Diva. He bought it. How can I handle work on a day like today? One of the worst performances of my career, and he never doubted it for a second. Hi, can I get my CRV brought up, please? I've got a lot to do today.
Roderick. Roderick.
You have excellent taste in automobiles. Life is packed with things you have to do.
But sometimes you gotta live a little.
Calm yourself, woman.
Matthew, you poor thing. You sound awful.
Resist.
Look, I don't know what to tell you. He's sick. Actors get sick sometimes.
Thanks.
Have a good night.
Said it before and I'll say it again. Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
Get going in the all-new CR-V from Honda.
You're still here? Do you have anything better to do? Go on, get going. Go.
and welcome to LCTV's first episode of the new semester. This is our Super Bowl prediction show. I'm Alex Stamos.
I'm Dan Snyder.
And I'm Matt Clark.
And we're going to be talking about Super Bowl 46 to be played this Sunday between the New England Patriots and the New York Giants. Dan, initial thoughts on the game.
Well, obviously, if people don't know this by now, yes, I'm a huge Patriots fan. But I've always told people, Patriots fan first, NFL fan second. As much as I want the Patriots to win this game, which everybody's saying they probably won't, I mean, they're the underdogs here in this situation, I'm just hoping for a great game.
Agreed. What about you, Matt?
I'm a football fan in general. I'm hoping for a tremendous game, a great game when the Giants can, again, upset the Patriots, who are favored by three. How is that the underdog?
Patriots are favored in this?
The Patriots are favored by three.
I've been hearing all week how they're comparing it to 07, how the Giants were the underdogs, and now the Patriots are seen as the underdogs, probably because of their defense, if you ask me.
Well, personally, I saw on Yahoo that the Madden simulation has the Giants winning this game 27-24.
Which isn't going too well for me because it's right 98% of the time.
Well, the last time it was wrong was the last time the Patriots and Giants played in the Super Bowl.
Was it now?
It was.
That's right.
Personally, I'm expecting a close game. I would be surprised if either team won by more than 7 points. Personally, I'm looking at a Giants victory just because I despise the Patriots.
Well, but I'm not surprised by that. A lot of people do.
You the lover or you hate them, the Yankees or the NFL?
Of course.
But the more important question, what will you guys be eating during the Super Bowl?
Ooh, that is a good question. Probably wings. Wings over Syracuse.
Wings, yeah. Wings. Has to be.
Zeppelin, right?
Yeah, maybe a step below. I'm favored by the DC-10. It's always a personal favorite of mine. Nice pound of wings. Just sets me over.
So, wrap it up. I want, from all of us, I want your Super Bowl score and prediction, and then give me your MVP for the game. I'll start with you, Dan.
Prediction for the Super Bowl, Patriots over the Giants. I'm going to go high scoring, because everybody says, the Patriots have the worst defense, 30th statistically in the NFL.
One of the worst.
Giants are 28th in pass defense.
This is
not true. A lot of people look past that because of their great defensive line, pass rush they can get, or the run rush they can get. I'm going to say Patriots 38, Giants 35, late second field goal.
Wait, second field goal by guy.
MVP, Wes Welker.
Wes Welker?
Yeah.
Going a little off the grid here. What do you think, Matt?
I'm looking at another repeat performance by the Giants to win by three, 30-27. I like the Giants' defensive line to eventually wear down the Patriots.
They do have a great defensive line. And five great players, all with great speed.
And despite the fact that the Giants lost five defensive backs during the preseason, I like Eli Manning to eventually overtake Julian Edelman and the rest of the great Patriots secondary.
Julian Edelman, that's nothing to say there. Nothing to say.
Well, personally, to break the tie, you know I'm going with. I have to go with the New York Giants. I'm going to go, since the Super Bowl score is never a conventional score, I'm going to go with 29-24 with the Giants. The Patriots are going to put up a last-second touchdown, miss the onside kick, but the Giants will win it, and then I'm going to go with Eli as my MVP, but I would not be surprised if Victor Cruz salsa dances his way to the MVP as well.
Pretty good prediction, if you ask me. But real quick, what do you mean by conventional score?
Like, rounded out numbers, like 28, 20, 24, like, you know, like that gets the averages out between a field goal and a touchdown.
Okay.
Like the Saints won 29-16, never a round number.
Exactly, never a round number.
Well, nevertheless, it should be a great game.
Exactly. So that's it for us here for our Super Bowl prediction show. Be sure to tune in to the Super Bowl this Sunday afternoon. Go Giants.
One more thing.